Have you ever wondered why birds can sit safely on electrical wires without being electrocuted? Why we use stones, pebbles, and gravels in a switchyard beneath power transformers? Follow me out through the video to find out the answers of these questions. Electricity is a flow of electrons from high potential to low potential points. So we need voltage or potential difference between two points to let the current flow. For example, if we have two different potential values on two wires and then we connect the two wires with a resistance, the current will start flowing from the high potential wire to the low potential wire through the resistance because we have a closed loop now. So in overhead transmission lines, if the bird sit on one wire from the three phase wires, nothing will happen because there is no voltage or potential difference produced. If the bird decided to move to sit on the pole and the tower was not well insulated, the bird could be electrocuted if it touched the tower and the wire at the same time, because the tower has a low potential value as the ground. Also, if we have a huge mythical creature that can touch two wires at the same time, a huge potential difference will be generated on the creature, and a huge flow of current will electrocute this pathetic. For power transformers, we use stones, pebbles, and gravels for more than one reason. The primary reason is to decrease the step voltage and touch voltage by increasing the soil resistance, which will reduce the risk of electrical shock hazards. If you don't know what is the step and touch voltages, you can check touch and step voltages video in the description down below to understand it exactly. Another reason for using stones beneath power transformers is to avoid entry of animals like rats, snakes, and lizards. For mechanical purposes, we use stones and pebbles to reduce vibration in the transformer. Stones and gravels also prevent the accumulation of water and the formation of puddles. Stones eliminate the growth of any small plants or grass, which can cause high moisture. Please feel free to ask any question, and Electrical Engineering Planet will try to answer it in the next videos. Don't forget to share, like, subscribe, and let the knowledge enlighten your world. Thanks for watching.